Hey, bro. Hit my intro.
What's happening, my visionaries? It's your man, J Rock. Back in effect. I'm live and direct, and I'm coming at your neck with yet another. Video, baby. Ah. The video, man, as always, just like, subscribe if you want to. If you don't, then just do it if you want to do it, because Jesus said this is the right thing to do.
What's happening, my visionaries? It's your man, J-Rob, man. Back up in the stand with S&D, another video, man. Y'all already know what it is, man. Fuck the intro. Black Sabbath, National Acrobat. You've been waiting very patiently, but it's here now. And it's time. The time has arrived. We are about to embark. We're on the precipice of one of the greatest rock bands of all time. So, allow us to be man, fuck it. Allow us to just listen to the damn song. Headphones are true. Bam, we gonna do what it do. Let's do it. First damn no. Iommi is the riff god, man. It simply cannot be debated. Like that. I like how it's dubbed and it overlaps the vibrato on it. Of course, Bill on the drums and Geezer on the bass, like, come on! Love this riff, man. I've lived a thousand times. I found out what it means to be believed. Ooh. Love Ozzy's harmonies on this too, man. The thoughts of really gives it a great stereo. The unborn child that never was conceived. Woo! Come on, Bill. Love the saturation on that, man. And backing memories are passed into the never ending well. Woo. The name that scorns the face, the child that never sees the cause of man. I was waiting for the damn breakdown. Come on. I'm talking to you. Well, I know. Love that wild one, man. It's up to you to know the reason why. And I know you'll come understand. On, but when it's time to die. Don't believe the life you have will be the only one. You have to let your body sleep to let your soul in my heart. Woo! Listen, man. I'm trying to get through. Love is give but life to you. And now he's up and done. Woo! I've seen how Tony is going off on this damn river. Oh, I love how they dub it with two guitars playing solos at different speeds and pace. Great mixing on that. Woo! This groove, man. Bill is in the pocket, dog. Deep in the pocket. Ozzy preaching on this one. Let it breathe, man. Let it breathe. Cause that track was motherfucking spicy, dog. Everybody was in their bag, which is just a colloquial for everybody was on point. Everybody in this, man, from Tony to Geezer to Bill to Ozzy, everybody was just completely synergistic in this song, man. There wasn't a moment where I wasn't enthralled and engaged with the composition, man. I mean, this track just exudes a technical proficiency and virtuosity of the ability of all of these musicians, man. I mean, I love the horn. I love the way this is mixed too, dog. I mean, shout out to the engineers of this song, man, because it was mixed so creatively. Love the way, you know, Tony's solo, that it was, you know, dubbed with two guitars playing at two different kind of speeds to give it a very jarring, a sort of disassociative effect, you know. I mean, my only slight grievance is that I wish the drums were just a little bit louder. But anyhow, man, Bill shined on this regardless. I mean, the drums penetrated through mostly everything else. But Deezer's bass was on point as always, man. Just Great damn song. Love the lyrics as well. I mean, I am the world that hides the universal secret of all time. Destruction of empty spaces is my one and only crime. I've lived a thousand times. I found out what it means to be believed. The thoughts and images, the unborn child that never was conceived. When little worlds collide, I'm trapped inside my... Love that internal rhyme, man. When little worlds collide, I'm trapped inside my embryonic cell. And flashing memories are cast into the never-ending well. The name that scorns the face, the child that never sees the cause of man. The deathly darkness that belies the faith of those who never ran. I mean, this is utter poetry, man. It is poetry. You got to believe, yeah, I'm talking to you, Willis. I know it's hard for you to know the reason why. And I know how you understand more when it's time to die. Don't believe the life you have will be the only one. You have to let your body sleep to let your soul live on. So I was gathering that as I was listening to the album. I mean, excuse me, not the album, but the song as well. That it seems to be themes of higher planes of existence, very metaphysical in the song. You know, ordaining some form of arcane mysticism that they kind of subscribe to. And yeah, I mean, I definitely enjoyed the listen to that. See, I want you to, I love the line, you have to let your body sleep to let your soul live on. Just kind of, you know, congruent with that idea of that you have to, essentially the aphorism of you have to die in order to be born again. You know, that the physical is merely the physical, but, you know, your soul lives on. Then I want you to listen. I'm trying to get through. Love has given life to you, and now is your concern. Unseen eye of inner life will make your soul return. Still, I look, but not to touch. The seeds of life are sown. Curtain of the future falls. The secret stays unknown. This is all very interpretive, but initially I was gathering that this was just a sort of... And I guess it could be twofold. It's sort of a parable, you know, it's proverbial words and philosophies and doctrines, like love is giving you to life to you, and now it's your concern. Unseen, the eye of inner life will make your soul return. Still, I look, but not to touch the seeds of life or sown. Curtain of the future falls, the secret stays unknown. Beautiful visual imagery, by the way, but... Very abstract. Just remember, love is life and hate is living death. Treat your life for what it's worth and live for every breath. Looking back, I've lived and I learned, but now I'm wondering. Here I wait and only guess what this next life will bring. Wondering what this next life will bring. So it kind of conflates those ideologies of, you know, higher planes of existence, you know, a place beyond the realm of this life. And also I was reading a little bit that a lot of people believe about the song is about the conception of the life of a sperm, an unborn child. It says the lyrics describe the thoughts of an unborn child. In the end, the lyrics give some general advice about life itself, that we are all born, we should live our life to the fullest. Yeah. So, I mean, there's alliteration. There's allusions to, you know, embryonic cell, the thoughts and images, the unborn child that was never conceived. So, yeah, I suppose, man. But anyhow, man, it'd be irrespective of what the lyrics are about. They're always interpretive. So that's just however you interpret it as. But I definitely did enjoy the song, man, and the composition, the structure of this as well, man. It was just great, great rock song, man. Sabbath is one of the best rock bands of all time. Like, once again, I'll reiterate, it's simply indisputable at this point. So, Anyhow, man, all I have left to say is, visionaries, I salute you. Remember, I say best never stress. Remember, I always do very best. Live love, love life, because why? Life is beautiful. That's why I'm going to catch y'all on the flip side. Deuces. Bye.
I'm sorry, don't get no one target, but I'm here for you and